We are back in the South Island of New Zealand. We're here on the West Coast as some of the most wild and rugged coastline in the world. And I'll be fishing it from a small dinghy, going 100 kilometres offshore to fish for one of the biggest, fastest, most powerful fish in the ocean, the giant bluefin tuna. These fish are built for fighting, and I'm going to try and catch one that weighs more than me and my boat combined. And I'll be using nothing but a simple hand line.
Oh, here we go. Oh, and there's no stopping these fish.
If I'm going to win this one, it will be the toughest fight of my life.
Grab a gaff, because it's just about ripping my bloody arm off.
And it's gonna hurt. I'd been warned of the perils of catching one of these giants on a hand line.
One of them had told me, don't do it, you'll get yourself killed.
Just one wrap of this rope around me and I could get dragged over or lose a limb.
Be careful of this rope, man, it's going.
So we first tried on our much bigger camera boat, where I could have guys standing by to cut the line should the worst happen.
Yo, we're back. Yeah, we're on. My hands are so cramped. It's burning, man, it's burning.
We proved that it was at least possible when I hauled in a giant bluefin tuna that we estimated at over 300 kilograms. But now, it was time to see if it could be done from my tiny 4-meter dinghy. So we departed from Westport in perfect conditions in search of the giant tuna that congregate out around the trawlers to feed on deep sea fish called hoki that spill from the giant trawl nets, as well as the fish scraps that get discharged overboard from the trawlers from their onboard fish factories. There have been countless hours of preparation and planning for this mission, but even so, it was the maiden voyage from my little boat, and taking it out on the open ocean of the Tasman Sea would be the ultimate test. It wasn't long until I was riding on rolling 3-meter swells out in the open ocean, well beyond the sight of land. And while the conditions were still reasonable now, the forecast is for the weather to deteriorate badly within the next 24 hours. So while I was still aching from handlining a giant tuna just yesterday, I had no choice but to make today the day to pull this off. So I pressed on towards the horizon. Finally, I located a trawler. It was the same one I had hooked my giant tuna next to yesterday. But this time, something is different. All was quiet on deck, and there was no crew to be seen anywhere.
Well, here we are. It's taken me over 3.5 hours to cover the 50 miles from Westport to make it out to the trawler. This is the same trawler that we caught our giant tuna right alongside yesterday, although at the moment it's not moving, it's just sitting idle in the water. Perhaps the crew are getting some well-earned sleep. There's no processing waste coming out, so we might have to start our own chunk trail. So this is all I've got really. Hopefully the noise of the engines is going to be enough to keep the tuna somewhere in the vicinity. My chunks of hoki that I'm going to throw in might attract a bluefin tuna, and then, all things going well, I might be able to catch a bluefin on a hand line out of my 4-meter stavy craft. Any tuna? Not today?
For over an hour, I fed chunks of hoki into the water, hoping that there was still some tuna here that I could attract to my bait. But without the massive amount of processing waste being pumped into the water from the trawler, there was simply not enough food here to satisfy the voracious appetite of the giant tuna. With the conditions worsening and time running out, the decision was made to head off in search of another trawler. The trouble was, the rest of the trawler fleet was further out to sea, and that meant another hour and a half pounding into the sea in my small boat. But I was not about to pack up and go home until I'd given this my very best shot.
Well, been running for another 15 miles further out to sea. We've only got an hour before dark. There's another trawler here. Hopefully there's some bluefin tuna with it. Guess really the only way to find out is to get my bait right in there, just like we did yesterday, and hope that we hook up. Can't see any, there's a few seals there. down deep.
The idea is to float my bait down the side of the trawler where the bluefin are waiting and eating the scraps as they are discharged from the onboard fish factory. But I had no bites. Still, I followed alongside the trawler as it cruised slowly further out to sea. And time after time, I continued to throw in my bait. Firstly, I'm hoping that there's still some tuna there. And secondly, I'm hoping that one would choose my bait out of the hundreds of chunks of fish that are drifting down through the water. For an hour, my bait remains untouched, and daylight is now running out. So with less than an hour of light left, one of our camera crew has come on board to drive the boat for me. This would speed up the process, and I could throw my bait in as many times as possible before dark. This was now a last-ditch effort. Some big game fishing boats also arrived to try their luck in hooking a giant bluefin tuna. But it seemed that the tuna were either not here or not interested in our baits. The long fight the day prior, the arduous travel and fading hope were all beginning to take a toll on my enthusiasm.
I'm tired, man.
I bet you are, mate.
By now, I've barely got enough energy left to stand up, but still, all I can do is continue to persevere until the very last minute.
Go, we'll go right near the front, and this time we'll let out heaps more line. Okay, just stay there. We don't want to pull out too far. We want to be able to sink, so we don't have too much drag on the line. So we just want to stay level with the line. So we're not creating a big belly that'll keep it near the surface.
Oh yeah, okay.
You know what I mean? So why don't you try a little sinker onto that swivel to get it to sink? Yo, yo!
Oh, yes!
What's that rope, mate? Just watch that rope. Just stay in neutral for now. That one's a tuna. Holy crap. Okay, we're running out of daylight and I've hooked up. Oh my goodness. Oh man. Whew. Well, here we go. Oh my gosh. I've got Ian who's come in the boat to sort of help me get a few more baits in the water because we're running out of time. We've chariled so far. I think it's going to be handy having Ian here just to coil that slack line behind me, because the last thing I want is a loop of line around me. Fish is straight down at the moment, Wooly. I'm getting quite a bit back already.
It's big too soon.
I don't know, might be a deep diving seal, bro. Maybe I got a bit more power in my arms after that warm up little one yesterday.
It was a long time to get that one, but good luck to him.
This fish is so much different from the last one I did on the hand line that screamed out my whole 250 metres of rope right at the beginning. This one's taken about 50 and he's dug in, which could mean that he's in for the long haul. And my arms were put through hell yesterday, not to mention the 5 or 6 hours it took me driving out here. Fortunately, the sea's levelling off. But I really don't know if we're gonna get this fish in before dark. Oh man. Oh, here he goes. Oh yeah. Go baby. Now while it's running down, it can't tow me. Which means all the weight has to go directly onto my arms. When it's running flat, all my arms have to take is the weight of this boat, which is considerably less than the weight of one of these tuna. I managed to stop him here. Oh. Oh, jeez. It's really woken up now, man. It's really woken up. Come on, baby.
Don't see it, Eddie.
Yeah, I know, I'm just wondering if he's still there. Yep. This fish could be charging back towards us. I don't know. Just can't really feel any weight. Oh man. Just go reverse, mate. Keep, yeah, no, just idle and just keep calling that line. Okay, neutral. I think he's gone. I've got no weight at all. Bugger. I've got rope around my feet, bro. Start calling faster. Ah. Gutted. Oh, hello. Well, we're on, people, we're on. Oh man, that was nerve-wracking. I must have pulled back in 100 metres of line then flat out with no weight on it. The weight came off all of a sudden, that fish must have just spun around and charged straight back at us. Oh man.
Yeah.
Straight down. Okay, I've just got this knot in the line that, whoa, that when it whipped out, gotta be so careful of. That's the sort of thing that can catch on you, and there's no stopping these fish. Or even then, it can just come straight through your hands, it'll just smash your hands to bits. It's gonna be pulled pretty tight, that knot, man.
Get it, man.
Yeah, because I don't want it coming through my hands again, eh? Fish is over this way. Fish is over here. Oh. Something feels pretty weird, eh? Hope he's not foul hooked or wrapped up. Oh dear. Reverse. Keep going, keep calling, keep going reverse. Okay, go neutral. No, we still got him. Oh man, it's nerve-wracking stuff. As charged as it does, as much as I want the pain in my arms to stop, it would be so much worse if I lose this fish after all the work that I've done to get it this far. When I say this far, I don't mean just the half hour I've been fighting it. The months of preparation that have gone into it. Go forward, Wally, please. Go forward, it's right under your boat. It's right here. It's coming up. Yeah. Oh yeah, the last thing then I want is to have it tangled in the propeller of the camera boat.
Tuna are one of very few fish that can pump heated blood to their muscle. This gives them tremendous power. But if they go on a prolonged run, they can actually overheat. Like the big tuna I hauled in yesterday. It burned itself out after taking big long runs.
Clip the harness on me. Clip it on.
But this one is fighting close and digging in.
Oh, jeez.
And these tuna have been fought here by crews for up to 36 hours, and even then, they've got away. I have no idea right now if this fish is even tiring at all. But as nightfall approaches, I do know one thing. I'm not going to be able to keep this up for too much longer.
These big ocean swells make my job even harder. It's about now that I'm starting to think I haven't even eaten today. Come on, I'm gonna let you go, buddy. And then we can both go home. Whoa, man, it's just spinning around and around, dragging us with it. Oh, whoa. Fish just dug down then as a swell lifted us up. Oh, he's away again. Oh man, this thing's got some go in it. Goodbye, son. See you in the morning. Oh! Oh man, that line is just cranking down. hope these relatively calm conditions hold.
Now, if I'm going to have any chance of outlasting this tuna, I'm going to have to take in some electrolytes to stop my muscles from cramping.
Thanks, mate.
Close. Nearly been an hour, must be pretty hard work. Turn them around a bit, backwards and forwards, side to side. We've got some time yet before we start.
Yes, that one around. Feeling pretty good at the moment, bro. Feeling pretty good. This is exactly where I want to be, and it's exactly what I want to be doing. Come on, baby. Oh, I can see it, I can see it!
Look!
Got colour! Tying us around in circles, far out. He's just spinning us around like we're nothing. Look at him, he's a nice one, man. He's a nice one. This fish is just, he's doing his circles, there's absolutely nothing we can do to stop him. Oh, I just can't get that leader up just that little bit more. I need to take a wrap. Man, he's right under your boat.
Right under your boat, boy.
Whoa, I had a wrap then. Smashed it through my hands. His green head, it's got heaps of go in him, man. It's a big one. Got two wraps on the leader now. My last bit of strength. The swell.
Going under the boat.
Oh, no, don't worry, mate. Okay, you can.
Well done, mate.
You can come in a bit closer, Willie. Switch doesn't want to give up. And I don't want to let go of my wraps. I don't want to let go of my wraps, but this fish is going to force me to in a second. I know. Those wraps are crimped into my glove. Gave him up in a sec, I hope.
Done,
you can come in a bit closer, Willie. Oh, I can see it. He is just going to pop a tag in it.
Tags in it.
Yeah! Oh, man. Still pulling hard, man. If you're going to take it, do you want to take it?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll grab a gaff because, it's just about ripping my bloody arm off.
While my original plan was to tag and release this tuna, the team decided they wanted to keep it to eat. But this fella is still a long way from the frying pan.
Well, the last minute these guys have decided they want to keep this fish to eat. Still got going it, bro. Over the top, place it and pull it in. Yeah! Tuna for dinner! Oh, man. Oh, I can't say anything. Oh, I'm so grateful that this came off. Thank you, Ian.
No worries, bro.
Thank you, Willie. Thanks, Kate. Thanks, Dylan. Thanks, Dave. Oh, man, what a team. It's going to make that long, lonely ride home in the boat so much more enjoyable, although I don't think I'm going to fit this tuna on this boat. It's going to have to go on the camera boat. Oh, that is awesome, just awesome. We'll pass you over this gaff rope, hey guys, and you can haul it aboard. You can haul it aboard. It's nowhere near as big as the last one, but... Yeah. Go boys, go pull it.
Go boys!
Go boys! Yeah.